Could we see the United States break up? The Balkanization of America. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcad channel. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. Now, we could see a scenario where you have various populations, various special interests, various entities within this country, essentially fragment the country into several other countries. Now, that's not something that I want to see, but that's something I want to talk about. I want to talk about how it could happen. I also want to talk about how we can sort of prevent something like that from happening. Because at a certain point, when a country is so divided where they can't even, where people can't even agree on fundamental things, it's very difficult for the country to be functional. You see a lot of dysfunction within the federal government. It's not as effective as even as it was, not that it was super effective at any given point, but it was effective enough. We made it to this point, and we're in a situation where a lot of people are losing confidence in the federal government. Even people, and it goes beyond just partisan politics, liberal versus conservatives. Obviously, you have this social aspect to things, this cultural aspect of things. You have this the rural areas where people are more pro-Second Amendment, more pro-gun, more religious, and you have these urban areas where people are not as religious, not as pro-Second Amendment, and you have these big divisions culturally. But it's also economically too, because you have an economy that favors certain counties, the urban counties, over the rural counties, and you have that big cultural divide. That's what's driving a lot of the division within the country. So if this country was to break up, what would it look like? Well, first, I'm going to talk about what I don't think it will look like. I don't think it will be a three-state situation where you have... I don't think it'll be a two-state situation either. I don't think you're going to have the West Coast and the East Coast forming one country, because it just wouldn't work geographically. Not when you have one big country separating both sides of the country. That wouldn't really make a lot of sense. And there's enough differences between the West Coast and the East Coast that they have different interests as far as money, as far as their economies. All right, I think you would actually see the Great Lakes area and the eastern part of the country. That's one scenario where the Great Lakes and the eastern part of the country, because I think they have more in common, even though you have states like Ohio and Indiana, which are obviously more conservative. But most of these states are pretty liberal for the most part. The western side of Pennsylvania is actually a lot more conservative. So you could actually see a breakdown where the border crosses through states. So you just wouldn't have like an entire state just go on to one particular country or another. I think even with this scenario, these three countries would be so big and you have so many competing interests, it wouldn't really work. Obviously, Colorado is a fairly liberal state. Texas and Utah are not. it looks like Georgia is becoming more liberal as well. I mean, it's just... Even when you look at Virginia, you may see a border cut through Virginia, separating Northern Virginia from the rest of Virginia. You may have California become its own country. You may have Texas become its own country. But anyway, moving forward, I think you could have a scenario where the Midwest joins, the Great Lakes region actually joins the middle of the country to form a different middle country. That could be a scenario, but again, you would have a lot of liberal states, such as Illinois, Michigan, Wisconsin, Minnesota, Colorado, Arizona, New Mexico, joining a pretty conservative hypothetical country. Some of you guys would sort of debate whether Arizona is liberal or not, but I think maybe a five state scenario might be a little bit more realistic, five or six actually. I'm going to talk about that a little bit more. First, the Northeast. The Northeast would be a pretty natural fit. I think you might even see a cut through Pennsylvania, but they would rely on Pennsylvania for a lot of the industry, parts of New York. I don't think New York City would be the capital of that Northeastern country, simply because it's not even the capital of its own state right now. I think Boston might be a candidate, but I think a compromise will probably end up being something like Philadelphia, probably. Obviously, this will be a very commercial, very banking center type of country. One of my concerns would be, because they're all in the Northeast, you know, they would have to definitely have a good relationship with some agricultural countries. Yeah, because, you know, as far as growing food and stuff. Okay, the Great Lakes. That's my mother's in Michigan. My family's in Michigan. I don't know if Kentucky would join that region. My best guess. This would be a really interesting mix of liberal states such as Michigan and Minnesota and Wisconsin and Illinois, with some conservative states: Ohio, Indiana, Kentucky, Iowa, Missouri. That would be really interesting. I think you'll have that country would be a country where you would still have plenty of rights, but it wouldn't be something that's far off to the left or far off to the right. So that might be an interesting scenario for a lot of people. The worst part about this stuff is that it would divide families, because people have, how many families have a brother in San Diego and a sister in Albany, New York? I mean, you know, or a sister in Tampa, Florida. I mean, that would be terrible. Anyway, the Southern, I think this would be the most, this would be something I would think would be most likely to happen as far as a Southern country here in the United States of America. Obviously, you got some poor states in here, some states where there's a lot of, there's poverty everywhere. I mean, it is, but you got some poor states here. But you also have free states too. You know, you also have, you got Texas, you got Florida. You have some pretty nice cities in, out of Texas, Houston. Austin might be the capital of the entire country right here. You got Nashville in Tennessee. You got Charlotte, North Carolina, Charleston, South Carolina. You got Atlanta, Georgia, Tampa in Florida, Miami in Florida, Jacksonville. A lot of good options. It would be a fairly conservative country with still a good amount of cities. That could be really interesting. But we'll see if immigration will change that demographic, change the politics of that area. Again, this is just my speculation. The mountainous states, mostly mountainous states. Colorado, obviously, being a pretty liberal or fairly liberal. I say that because they have a gun ban, ban on gun magazines over 15 rounds. But yes, I'm still talking about that. But Arizona, obviously, is now a blue state. Well, it seems it's trending blue for sure. New Mexico has been a blue state for a while, but then the rest of these states, Montana, Idaho, and the Dakotas, and Nebraska and Kansas are red states, and they're more conservative states. Utah, obviously, a conservative state. So it's a major city. This country still has some decent cities: Boise, Idaho, Salt Lake City, Phoenix. You know, it's still Denver. Denver will probably be the capital of this country right here. Then there's the West Coast. I think California would definitely dominate there. Maybe California could become its own country. There's talk of, you know, maybe Northern California becoming a separate state. I've heard that a while ago. This will be interesting. This will be a fairly liberal state. But, you know, the divisions could go beyond just the traditional state lines. You know, you got a situation where Northern California may join Nevada, most of Nevada, and Nevada may break off from the southern part, which is basically Las Vegas. I mean, but who knows? I mean, who knows? You know, you have a scenario, like when you look at Washington State, the Seattle on the west side is very liberal, but then the rest of the state, all east, it's fairly conservative. They're pretty pro-gun. You got a similar situation with, similar situation with Oregon. You got Portland, a very liberal, the city, and then you got the rest of it. There's other cities too, of course. There's other cities, of course, but this is something to think about. So, I want to talk about, well, this is what it'll pretty much look like overall. How do we actually avoid this? There's some things we got to do to avoid a scenario where the country breaks up into pieces. First off, nationalism. I'm not saying we got to go overboard with it, but I like the idea of America coming first. That's what, one of the things I like about Donald Trump. Whether you're a liberal or conservative, at some point we have to decide that American interests should come before the interests of the globalists, of not just foreign interests, the global interests. We have to decide that, hey, this is our country, this is gonna, our interests are gonna come first. Feeding our families will come first. And not, okay, we're gonna give people a $600 check, but then we're gonna spend, like, I don't know, millions of dollars on a gender program in Pakistan and send $1 billion to the Egyptian military and all this other nonsense. I mean, at some point, we need leadership, a change of leadership where America has to come first. Some type of nationalism. We don't have to agree on every issue. We just have to agree that, hey, at the very least, America should come first. That's something we have to agree on. Populism. That's something I think is going to be really important. You can call it populism, the idea that we should put the interests of the everyday, the average person forward instead of just focusing all on the elites, all on the big tech, the massive corporations. If you're a liberal, you would probably say income inequality and all this other stuff. This bottom line is we have too much of is a lack of economic opportunity, okay? It's too much of the political force, too much of the energy in this country is being focused on a small, very, very small group of people, small group of, not even people, really corporations. That's a big issue. I'm not anti-corporation. I just don't think corporations should have the same rights as a human being. I mean, I think they need to be held accountable. If I have to be held accountable, then corporations should be held accountable. At some point, we have to economically, we have to bring the jobs here to the U.S. We cannot have all this manufacturing overseas and all these people unemployed in the United States of America and think this is the whole show is going to stay together. It just doesn't make any sense. Bill of Rights, either we believe in the Constitution or we don't. Bill of Rights, either we believe in it or we don't. We can't cherry pick, especially the Bill of Rights. I mean, come on. You know, freedom of speech. That needs to be applied online, on the internet as well, okay? Freedom of religion, all this other stuff, this has to continue to be relevant. It has to be a real thing. Freedom of assembly, but that doesn't mean that, you know, Antifa has a right to burn cities down or terrorize people. I mean, come on, you know, we have to protect people's rights. Second Amendment, this is a major fracture point within this country. Too many people will believe that, you know, this is something that should be taken away from others. We need to stop fighting over something like this, because ultimately, it doesn't benefit us to start taking away our rights. I'm not going to go over all the rights that we have, Fourth Amendment protection against unreasonable searches and seizures, and Fifth, and, you know, the Bill of Rights. Either it means something, or the Constitution either means something or it doesn't. These are three things that we definitely got to do in a hurry. Economically, culturally, we got to get on board with this, because if we're not careful, we can end up in a situation where we could have, people are talking about civil war. Well, you know, what could be the end result of that? Five or six different countries, you know, these countries may or may not have diplomatic relations. Five or six countries, maybe third world countries. I mean, that's not going to do us any good if we got five or six third world countries in what used to be the United States of America. I know I didn't mention Hawaii. I have no idea what's going to happen there. Alaska, I have no, maybe they might join Canada or something. I don't know. I mean, that's going to be a situation there too, because the people in Alaska are used to having certain gun rights that Canadians don't have. So that should be, although Canadians can own guns, it's different. So it should be interesting. So I want us to avoid that situation. I want to know what you think we need to do to avoid a breakup of the United States of America. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Oh yeah, free and fair elections.